Hi beautiful angels, this is Mystic C from Magic Gwen Stereo and this is your most requested and most juicy pick a card reading. How your January romance and love life will be. Yes friends, so many of you requested this reading, here it is now. I will be taking some initials also as you requested, initial charms. Yes friends, and this is a general reading. It may resonate or it may not, so take whatever resonates, leave the rest behind. And friends, this is a timeless reading. Even though it is for January, you can watch it anytime. It will still help you and resonate with your situation. And make sure to subscribe Magic Gwen Stereo, like and share friends, because if you subscribe, like and share, you get a chance to win a free reading at the end of every month. One random subscriber will be selected by random name picker for will be winning a free reading. So so get ready, subscribe, like and share, and join us on Instagram as Magic Gwen Stereo. To buy a personal reading, visit our website www.magicgwenstereo.com. That's it for our announcement. You want to buy your personal 2021 reading, go to our website friends, you can order yours. And 2021 is going to be a very exciting year, so go for it friends, go for it. So let's not talk further, let's take a deep breath, relax. And today's choices are very, very beautiful. So let's choose option number one, this beautiful pink butterfly. It's flying. Option number two, this beautiful blue butterfly. Option number three, this beautiful green butterfly. So relax, take a deep breath, choose option 1, option 2, option 3. I will leave the timestamps friends in the comment section so you can directly go there and skip to your option. You can watch the entire video, you can choose more than one also. So get ready friends, let's see if you choose option number 1. Let's see what will happen in January for you, your love life. Let's see that. This pink butterfly, very, very pretty butterfly, very, very pretty. Let's see, these are your romance angels, these are your oracle messages. Let's see friends, how your love life will be in the month of January. Oh my God, transformation, big changes are coming in your love life. Get ready friends, get ready, something big is going to happen, something big is going to shift, transform. I see changes because you see that butterfly and you see this rose. It is like something is manifesting in your love life in January, something that you have not you don't know about it yet. And you will also be getting freedom from your past. Something is going to end and something fresh is going to start in January. January is going to actually transform your love life. And it will open your heart. It will open your heart. Look, Eight of Swords. Yes, January you are going to break free of restrictions. Of mind, of your heart. If you are putting, if there is any restriction in your life, like someone is restricting any relationship or any belief or any, like, you want love but you feel like maybe you need to change a city, you just can't find it here. So anyone that's stopping, you're gonna change it, you're gonna leave that behind, you're gonna say bye bye. You want your freedom friends in January. Freedom is very important. Liberation, transformations, big changes, Chariot, movement is coming in your love life friends. Yes, I see your love life will be picking pace friends. You will be either traveling or someone will meet you while traveling or holidaying or while you are going for a job interview or something, or for your work, that's when you are going to meet somebody. Temperance, yes, balance will be coming into your love life. You are going to meet people who will balance you or who will support you. So get ready. I feel like, somewhere you are focusing on yourself in January, self-love and on your ambitions, your goals, but you will still find people who are supportive and helpful. And look, the moon, yes, romance is coming. The romance is very high for you in January, so get ready. I also feel that with this moon, things may seem confusing for you in January. Like, what is going on? Why can't you see the whole future? Why can't you see the whole story now? Things will feel a little confusing in January regarding your love life. And you may feel like, you know, if you are already married or in a relationship, you may want to fly out of it, or you may want to change something in it. Like, you know, take a holiday, or you want your partner to give a lot, be more romantic. You know, you might, someone might do a romantic dinner for you, sing a song for you, compliment your beauty, send you some poems or poetries. So, you know, it is that energy where you are, there is a lot of emotion, there is a lot of romance, but you don't know where it is going, because the future you don't know. This is very intense energy. Chariot, Temperance, Moon, Death, it is very intense. So you are drawing very intense connections in January. You will feel very strongly about your love life. Even if you are single, your emotions are high. You want to change that. You want to mingle. You want to be in love. Let's see. King of Swords, wow. Aquarius, Libra, Gemini person is coming towards you, or a Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces person, a very strong Scorpio person is coming. So get ready. I see, you know, you are clear what you want in January. You are clear right now also what you want. Like, you want love, or you want something else. You're very clear, like, I want to be focused on my goals. You know what you want, but love is coming and emotions will be high. Changes are going to happen. Someone from the past may return, or you may leave a you know, old situation, maybe a shift, relocate, or something, old job, old house, or old relationships. You will leave, and that is when you're going to find an emotional connection. Maybe from online or while you are traveling, that is when you will meet them. Cancer, Page of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces person. Yeah, I think there is a person coming towards you who will offer you love. Pile number one. This person could be younger than you, or you have an age gap with them. They are from some another country or city and another religion probably. It could be a same-sex relationship for some of you. So this is a new person coming in. They are young, they are a bit shy. And you might be like, I don't want love, I'm busy. But it's coming, friends. So something you need to change, friends, in this year. Okay, probably in this year. Because if you don't shift it in January, you might still have to shift it in the year. So you need to, you know, you need to, maybe you are putting, you're not, love is around you, but you are not seeing it in January. Secondly, love, people are coming, but you don't want love, so that needs to change. Somewhere you need to forgive the past, that also is necessary. So a lot of things are important this month for you. Let's see what else. Building blocks, number 28. Yes, someone, a strong relationship potential person is coming. Someone who wants to build a future, or build this connection, or a friendship with you. So that person is coming. Peace. Number 23, you will find peace and relief, friends. There are some endings which are bothering you. There, like, maybe the past, the what, why this ending happened, why you are still single when everyone else has found someone. So, you know, you will find some relief this month. Peace. You will be like, yes, I have attained peace. Something will happen which will give you a ray of hope, which will, you know, increase your faith in love and life. Something which was over may start again, or someone better may come into your life. So peace is coming, friends. You know, look at this egg. Something is being born. You can't see it right now. Maybe it will take longer than January to manifest or appear in your life, like this relationship or something, but it is coming. It is there. It is already around you. Ace of Cups. Friends, love is coming. A very, very deep romantic connection is coming. I also feel your self-love will be very high. You're gonna feel a lot of love for yourself, a lot of connection, you know, a lot of harmony. You're gonna start enjoying yourself, and that is how, or with this person, this new connection, you will feel a lot of harmony, a lot of commitment, a lot of creativity. it is with a new start for you. It is a new start for you. So let's see what else. Okay. Wow, foundations and achievements. This is interesting. So definitely, you know, your focus is on work. Your focus is on your future. Your focus is on achievement. But someone wants to build a strong foundation of friendship or love with you. And it will be like a ray of hope. I think once you have given up on love, that's exactly when love comes into your life. So January is that month for you where you end things with the from the past and you are like done with it. And you heal and something else comes into your life. It could also be like if you were dealing with a twin flame, now you will feel like you can live without them, without feeling like you are incomplete or something, you know. So it's a relief for you. Let's see your love message, then we're gonna see your charms. Who? It's beautiful friends. It is safe for you to love, open your heart to give and receive the highest energy of love. I'm so sorry, the camera keeps sliding. So yeah, I think love is coming for you in January. A lot of love, a lot of peace is there, a lot of self-love is there. But you need to say yes. Otherwise, you know, I see that you might say bye-bye to it. I don't know why. So say yes to love that's coming. Let's see some rituals for pile number one for January. Coming in January for January. Can't believe it. This is January 2021. We are doing the readings. You remember when we did readings for January 2020? I still remember. That was one time, you know. We were not like, nobody was expecting 2020 would go like this. And actually, we were, but like, it would go to this extent. That is what nobody was expecting. Mart could be a name for somebody. Mart or Maru could be a name. Mary could be a name. Someone named Mary. Manny could be a name for some of you. There is this energy, there is a blank. So if your person's name is not here, it could be the blank that you can use. So there is many partners are coming for you, or friendships are coming for you. It feels like friendships are coming. It is time for you to say yes. There is also the alphabet D here, E here. There is also alphabet O. There is M. There is P. There is J. There is Y. So yeah, so these are your, I can only make out these. Rao can also be a name for somebody. So there is a blank, there is UNT, MANI, ROUU, and ODE, JY, P, and M. So these are your alphabets. Make sure to subscribe. That's it for now for January. And see you next in another video. Make sure to subscribe, like, and share Magic Wins Tarot. This is Mystic C saying bye. So friends, if you choose option number 2, this beautiful blue butterfly, let us see what is coming for you in January 2021. Let's see your love life and romance. These are your oracle messages, and this is your romance angel's message. We'll also be pulling the charms, initial charms from here. So let's see what's going to happen in your January. Oh my God, Five of Cups. You're missing somebody. You're missing somebody. Someone is missing you. I think you are a little disappointed with the way things have been in your love life, or with, you know, how a person is behaving. You're missing someone. Someone long distance, no contact situation. They are also missing you. And this relationship is not over yet. There is still hope in this connection. It is up to you whether you take them back or not. But there is still hope in this connection. They are missing you. Someone is crying over you. Ten of Swords. Yeah, this ending was bad. But I don't think so. This situation is over. No. This situation, this past relationship isn't over. also for some of you, I feel that you have not really recovered from a heartache. You are still somewhere hanging, or you know, still waiting for that lover of the past to come back or to heal you. I think this is like someone never gave you a closure in a relationship. You know, when someone doesn't end a relationship well, it kinds of creates that energy of vacuum, you know. It kinds of keeps that, you know, stuck. It makes, you know, it is like a jam. It's like a vacuum where nothing now shifts. It's stuck. So, you know, I think it's nice to give people closures, and, you know, it's very important. Actually, it's not only nice, it's very important. So I think there are two energies I'm feeling in January. Someone is missing you, someone who ended things with you. They are missing you, long distance, no contact person. You are also missing them. Other situation is in January, friends, you are healing. You're still grieving a heartache. You are still not over this person. You're still waiting for them. Whether you like it or not, you are waiting for them. And you still have a hope, maybe a 1% or maybe a 0.10001%, like, yay, this person might come back. Or explain, maybe they could explain why this happened with you. The Seven of Swords, yeah. Someone ghosted you and you are not happy about it. Someone ghosted you, someone blocked you, someone stabbed you in the back. It's not fun. You are recovering from it in January. It will take some time. Even if you feel you have recovered from this, which happened in the past, you are still recovering, friends. It's not over yet. Six of Swords, yes. In January, I see you moving out of this situation into freedom. Look at this. So you are going to move out of these troubles, this pain. And some of you might be traveling this month, which will help you to heal your heart. I also feel that for some, you know, it's 50-50. This person might come back also for some of you and things will get better. But for others, 50% of you, this is your self-healing will happen and you will be able to move on from this setback. You know, you will recover. I think you are still crying. Maybe they are also crying, your person. I see you crying right now. I don't know why. So maybe in January you will cry a little. Like you are crying because, you know, because of all this, what has happened, maybe you are traveling, you have to move out, relocating or something. So that's why you are crying. Or maybe your best friend or someone who helped you is moving away. So you are like, why? You are a bit emotional in January, but you will feel quickly better also just after crying. Queen of Cups. Yeah, your emotions are very high, friends, this month. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces person, your emotions are extremely high. And I think you will find an emotional maturity in yourself. Like you will learn how to deal with your emotions. Two of Swords. Some decisions are pending for you in January. You know, like you're not sure whether to stay or move away from this person. I do see that this person might try to contact you, or they might try to, you know, message you on social media, or they might stalk you, or they might send a friend to talk to you. So they are like, why? You are like, why now? It will confuse you. Like, why is this person coming back? Because, you know, they have hurted you and they realized it. This is something is off balance in your love life, friends. In January, it will balance out. And those who have hurted you, they are going to get their karma back, or you are going to get a better partner. So, you know, you are going to get better or recover from this heal, from this heartache. So some justice will happen, friends. If you know, it may take time, but it usually happens, justice. So don't worry. Keep yourself emotionally mature in January. The Fool, a new start is going to happen. Yes, friends, you are very, in fact, you are already on the path of a new love relationship or a better future of your love life. Blue, about changes. Look, all the cards are blue here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Even the here also, if you see the background is blue. Everything is blue here. So, you are moving towards happiness, towards clarity, towards wisdom, towards maturity, and good relationships are coming. See Five of Wands, competition. I see that, you know, there might be in your relationships a bit of competition or jealousy this month. Or, you know, someone is like, you want to move on from a past lover, but they are like, no, I want to talk to you. I love you now. I won't let you go now. So you have to like really fight them off this month. Like, I don't want you. And I also feel there is someone new coming, but you will not, you might be confused whether to accept them or not because of these past trust issues. So something is happening, something is really happening. And I think it's a good month for you. You just need to be patient, you know. I see this number two. So number two is important. So maybe January might be like the month of healing and clarity in your love life. And February is actually the time when you start the new year and you're like, Happy New Year. Let's see the other cards. Yay, number two. Wow, I said two and look, the two card appeared here. Yeah, friends, you know, a sweet connection is coming your way. Don't worry. A very sweet proposal or someone who likes you and the, you know, the very sweet loving connection, someone who compliments you is coming. So stay open and heal yourself from this past. Heal yourself. Someone who will shower you with affection, gifts, you know. So get ready. What is this? Mending? Number 52, yeah. Your heart will heal, friends. And I have a feeling that this past relationship will heal. It will heal energetically or in physical. Like this person will come and talk to you, so things will heal. Otherwise, it will heal on spiritual level, you know, spirit level. Discontent and boredom, four of cups. Yeah, you may feel like, you know, you are not getting anyone who is like you, because you are very emotionally intelligent. Your IQ has become emotional intelligence, or you have become emotionally very, you know, refined. You are like the best diamond now. So nothing matches you. There might be a sense of boredom for you in January. But look at that, throat chakra, number 5. I do see messages are coming, even though, again a blue card. Oh my God, it's all blue here. This is fantastic. Blue is your color, friends, for January. And I definitely feel that this is the month of change for you in your love life. There is a potential of this past or current relationship to get better and this person to speak their truth, their love. I see they are hiding their love from you. You know, they love you a lot. This person keeps crying over you, but they are hiding it. They are just hiding it. And in fact, they keep fighting with you instead of telling you how much they love you. So someone is coming to show you how much they love. Also, I see a lot of spirit messages, you know, like 555, 444s will be seen to you in January. Blue color will be very like blue. You see blue butterflies or you see blue things around you a lot in January. It is a sign for you that things are getting better. You are recovering. Let's see your romance angels. Ooh, that's so interesting. A new person has stirred your romantic feelings. A new lover is coming your way. Congratulations, friends. Yes, some of you exactly wanted that, a new lover, because you are done with the past. I also feel it could be a renewed connection, you know. You heal from the past and, or maybe this new person, this past person is healing and, you know, they return in a new form to you. I feel for most of you, it is a new person. But you will recover from the past also. Option number two, what will happen to them in January? So let's see. Wow, rat. Maybe some things are moving at a slow pace, you know, like rat pace, you know, like, you know, someone is very naughty, you can't trust them, you know, like rats are very you know how they are mischievous, you can't catch them easily. So you are like, catch me if you can. There is like a new romance coming which you can't understand or catch easily. Rat is, this person could be from the past also, you know. What else? I can't make any other word. Maybe gratitude. I feel be grateful for whatever happened, friends. Gratitude is here. So be grateful, you know. Everything happens for a reason. Even if we don't understand that reason right now, everything happens for a reason. Sometimes it takes us a while to understand. Number five, changes. Gratitude. Stay grateful for the new love coming your way. And what else can we make? Gauri can be a name here. Gauri can be a name for some of you. Gauri is also a goddess, mother goddess, mothering god, you know. Gauri, the goddess, mother energy. Look at that, yin, feminine energy. So friends, keep your heart open, don't close your heart. Love is coming your way in January, a new love or a renewed love. What else is there? I can only see these words right now. TURATGURIOOIOM. And there is J. And there is L also here. There is Y. There is R. And there is X. See, the X is also here. So yeah, someone from the past is coming. If you can make more words out of these, let me know. Subscribe Magic Wands Tarot, like and share. Bye for now. So friends, if you chose option number 3, this beautiful green butterfly, it's so pretty. Let us see how your January love and romance will be. Let's see that. Don't forget to watch your 2021 horoscope readings with charms. I'll try to tag them up. They are in the playlist. You can go and check that out. All signs, your signs reading. These are your oracle messages, your romance messages. I'll be pulling some charms, initials also. Let's see how your January will be. Happy New Year! Friends, Happy New Year. How are you feeling? I think you are feeling bored right now. You are feeling like someone is messaging you or trying to date you, or someone wants your attention, but you are like, you're bored. I think you're bored of the way things are right now, with the way the world is, with the way the love life is, with people who are coming, trying to, you know, you're bored with the way love is. Really bored. Seriously. And you start January like that, like, oh, I don't know, I'm discontent, I'm bored, I don't know, what is love? What is love? And I think it's a good question for you, because in 2021, it is time for us to find new ways to love. What is love? What is love to you? It is actually the right things you are asking. It is not a wrong question. It is a right question. Six of Wands. Success is coming, friends. I think you start the January feeling very bored. Like, oh my God, I'm so bored. I'm so lonely. I'm so bored. But I think things will pick up quickly in your romantic life. So, get ready. Excitement is coming. Something will make you, someone will move towards you, message you. I see someone will compliment you, or someone will try to date you. I think this person is already in your life right now. But things will get exciting with them in January. The Hermit. Yeah, you know, this person is, there is someone who is keeping their feelings hidden from you. I think in January, they will try to reveal their hidden secret feelings, emotions, passions for you. You may also be having some secret, affection for somebody, and you will tell that person, or you will try, you know, a crush, you will try to message them, and I think things will go better. You both like each other, or you will start talking. I also see you are looking very... You know, you are looking very deeply about your love life. Like, what is love? That's the big question for you. What is love? To love or not to love? That's the big question. I think you will find a solution for that in January. You will ask me why the readings are different this time, or why they sound different. They don't sound different, friends. We are moving into times which are different. 2021 is not like any other year we have ever been to. just like 2020. In 2021, we can't talk the same old things. We can't. Even if I try, I can't. Because we all have changed. We all are not who we used to be. We are all different. It's beautiful. And you're going to, you know, someone is coming. Someone likes you. They are keeping an eye on you in January. And they will compliment you and they will try to win you. It could be a coworker or someone you study with or someone you worked with. You know, your past colleague or someone, your boss also. So they are keeping, they are watching. They are waiting for the right moment to approach you. Maybe they tried to message you in the past, but you were like, nah, nah. You're very quick, you know. You guys are like, no, I don't want to talk. Bye. Hey, good night. I'm busy. I'm sleepy. I think this person tried to talk to you 4 months back. Or maybe 4 days back or 4 weeks back, you know, last month or something. But they will come back again. This person, this co-worker, this secret admirer, Nine of Pentacles. See, they are like, oh, she's the one, he's the one. They have their eyes on you. I keep getting that song, BTS Savage song. So go listen to that song. I don't know why. Maybe you all like those, that BTS Army or something. You like that song. You know, they are looking at you like, yeah, that's the catch. She's so amazing. He's so amazing. They like you. They like you. They work with you or you are, you know. Then they are from social media. They like you. They care for you. They are keeping an eye on you in January. Two of Pentacles. I think this person could be from a different city or country. And a long distance person. They live near water or you live near water. I feel they are going to message you. But you will be like, hey, I want to meet you. I don't want the long distance. I don't do LDRs. I want to meet you. And or you might pretend that you are very busy. You don't have time for love. So a lot of things are happening, you know. Like a lot of things is happening. Like you're busy. There are people trying to. I also think like love will come in January when you are having a promotion. Or when you are very busy at work. Or with your studies. Or with the, you know, you are traveling, you know, like for a college or for exams or for some work. You are very busy. You got a new project. And that is when they, boom, this person expresses all their love to you. And you're like, what? What a timing. Ace of Rods. There's a lot of passion. It's a passionate, sexy connection coming your way. So get ready for some winter love, friends. Get ready. Yeah, yeah. So savage love it is. I think there is a song called Savage Love also, but BTS Savage is also their song. So this is a passionate connection, and it, you know, it will start very you might take some time to say yes, but once you say yes, this will be a very passionate, steamy, sexy, hot relationship for you. This person is all gaga over your beauty. This person is all like, wow. You know, they like you. I think you also like them in some way. Like you're also keeping an eye on them. The sun, yeah. Your love life is very exciting in January. Or even if you don't actually do something, you will find an eye candy in January. You know, like someone you can look and, you know, enjoy. Like sometimes you meet such people whose eyes are very beautiful. You like looking into them at your school and colleges. Or they dress very sweetly. Or they speak very sweetly. So that's how it will be. You will like to see each other, meet each other. For some of you, this could be a marriage proposal or someone like from social, you know, dating sites or someone. So, you know, the initial, you might meet for dating or, you know, the initial attraction, the spark is there. So you will like it. It will be nice. For some of you, it is your twin flame you will be connecting with in January. So, yeah, the Hanged Man. But you will still take it slow, friends. You will not rush this connection, even though there is a very lot of potential attraction, love. There is like overflowing emotions, magnetic attractions, sexy passion, and you love them, they love you, but you are like, nah, I wanna wait. Why? I don't know. You are very deep about love. You don't want quick things, but you will enjoy this romance or attraction coming your way. Because, you know, you are changing your views about love, what love used to be. You are letting go of control on life. Earlier, you used to control your relationships. It didn't work. Now you are like, let's see what happens. We're gonna take a chance on life. and it's bringing you love. King of Pentacles, this person could be Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus, or you could be Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus. This person could be Aries, Leo, Sag also, or you could be Aries, Leo, Sag, friend. So a lot of attraction, a lot of passion is there, but this feels more like in January, you know, a date or some sort of a friendship or, you know, new connection. It feels like somewhat like someone is busy, you both are busy, so you are keeping it to flirtations, keeping it to, you know, you are taking your time, you don't want to rush into it. So there is this connection, attraction, burning sensations, but you're gonna like, I'll take my time. Message in a bottle, yeah, someone is going to message you, someone is dying to message you, that's the right way to put it. This person lives near sea. I think you should watch that movie also. The Notebook, I keep getting that movie, The Notebook. Maybe it's their favorite movie or it's your favorite movie. Observer, oh my God, this is goosebump moment for me. Whew, okay. See, this person is keeping an eye on you. You are also keeping an eye on them, if you know them. Otherwise, they are definitely, and they're gonna message you. They can't control anymore. They're gonna message you. Firm foundation, Four of Pentacles. This person, you know, you will take some time. You will be like, I need some time to decide. And I think, you know, you will, although there is a lot of harmony, like see this, lot of passion, a lot of connection. You have like mental connection, emotional connection, passionate connection, but you will not rush this connection. Fulfillment of your wishes, Nine of Cups. Yeah, you will meet your friends, you will meet and, you know, enjoy with them. You will take them or they will take you out on a date, or maybe it is your birthday, so they might surprise you, or it is their birthday. So, you know, there is love, there is fun, there is flirtations, but you avoiding something serious. Romance angels, calling your soulmate, your prayers, affirmations, visualizations help bring you together. So yeah, if some of you are already manifesting a lover, yes, you are on the right path. Chances of meeting them in January are high. Also, for others of you, you may like this person that you are dating them, or you just met, or this stranger, or this secret admirer, but you may be still not satisfied. You are like, I want something deeper. I don't want this lustful, flirty connection. I want something like this King of Pentacles, grounded connection, marriage potential, husband, potential wife. So you are like, I will manifest. I'm gonna manifest, no one gonna stop me. That's how you feeling, friends. Let's see your messages. Option number 3. Okay, let me just turn the words up so we can know what they are. Wow, I can see a tower movement. I don't know, it's you can see a tower. Maybe you will meet them near a tower, or you know, a monument, or maybe you know, this person works like in technical, you know, mobile companies, telecommunications, electronics, or some other things like that. Also, this person may come very unexpectedly, like a tower movement in your life, like suddenly out of nowhere they are there and you're like, whoa, 2. I also see the number 2. So maybe this is like you will meet 2 people in January, or you know, this is like this is like one person, new person coming, but you want a second person because you are not happy with them, or you find them too flirtatious. That is also there. I see the name Tina here. Tina. So maybe that name is important for some of you. What else can we make? I see nail here, N-A-I-L, nail. Yeah, so maybe, you know, this person something, maybe if she's a female, she has wonderful nails or nail color, or maybe you know your nail can also be like you are looking for a grounded connection, like this firm foundation, like this firm foundation, this nailed it into the ground. You want that connection. You don't want just a flirty connection. So that can also be there. What else? Near. Yeah, someone is, you know, someone is near to you, or someone wants to come near to you in January. So a lot of messages are coming for you. So let's see. There are a lot of yous here. Three yous and eyes. There is I, and there is TWONEARLIIU, and there is U, there is L, there is A here, there is S, and there is E, and there is the letter C, alphabet C, you know, word C. So this person lives near sea, water, oceans, or something like a lake or something. Maybe you will meet near water or oceans, or maybe a water park or water. Wait, what do you call those things where you drink water? You know, those dispensers where you fill glasses of water and you can drink it. I don't know, there is something you call that machine, you know, water dispenser, I think so. So yeah, a lot of things are coming your way in January. Happy January. Subscribe Magic Wands Tarot, make my January amazing. If you want to donate to our channel, some of you wanted to donate to our channel, thank you so much. You guys are amazing friends, thank you. It means a lot, especially in this year. Things have been really tough, and I don't usually talk about it, and things are getting very expensive, trust me on that. And you know, so yeah, so thank you so much for some of you who donated to our channel. If you want to donate anything to our channel, just email me, I'll get back to you. Thank you so much, and this is Mystic C saying bye.